definitely abhorrent.
Justice V. R. Krishna Iyer, former Justice of the Supreme Court, the period he functioned as Home Minister and Law Minister of Kerala, is still considered to be the golden era of Kerala. The Indian government honored this great man with one of the highest award of the land, Padma Vibhushan, in recognition of his timeless service for social justice and human rights.
God gave life, and only God can take life, God back. So definitely, forced by society, by government, is very outrageous in my view. It is anti-human.
By the time I reached the last stage of my judgeship,
Justice Katie Thomas, one of the three judges who acquitted 19 accused individuals and confirmed death penalty on four accused, including Peeradibalan, in the Rajiv Gandhi assassination case.
I concluded that the penalty is not a penalty or not a punishment at all. It is a judicial murder. A murder committed by the society with the help of law. So I am against it.
An offender should not be considered as an offender always.
Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, founder of Art of Living, who propagates the art of living through yoga. The saint who visits the prisons of the world and helps the inmates undergo transformation in their lives.
A situational accused must be consistently given chances to reform himself. Giving death penalty to the offenders will not ensure a fall in the crime rates.
Mahatma Gandhi has been against death penalty. Jawaharlal Nehru has been against death penalty. On the whole, the conditioning of our Vedic culture of India, Valmiki downwards, has been opposed to death penalty.
Death penalty is a must. Only then they will regret their crimes.
Those who have to be reformed have to get reformed. Capital punishment is not appropriate.
They should be hanged.
Hanging a person affects his family and generations to come.
Only death penalty will reduce crimes.
We must give him a chance to change.
Death penalty must be abolished.
Then how else the culprits could be punished?
Death penalty will not ensure the culprits' repentance.
We all know the story of Kannagi and Kovalan. An innocent was beheaded because of a wrong judgment.
Periyar Thidal, the memorial of Tandai Periyar, the rationalist who is regarded as the father of Tamils. Jolarpet, Vellore district. Peeradibalan is the second sibling of the couple Nyanasekaran and Arpudam, born in the year 1971.
I have three children. Elder daughter is Anbumani. Next is my son Peeradibalan.
He used to play a lot with my father. My father also liked to play with him. I was always hard pressed for time. But Peeradibalan and his sisters were more like friends. And I never interfered in their affairs.
He would never walk up to anyone easily. He was very shy. But if he liked someone, he would speak for hours. He loved rearing pigeons. Being an important junction, many goods trains pass through our station. Cereals like rice, millets and maize are transported in these trains. As children, our hobby was to collect the spilled cereals for the pigeons.
Jolarpet Government School. Peeradibalan studied in the school. By virtue of discipline, charity and leadership, Peeradibalan enjoyed high regards from students and teachers alike.
Peeradibalan's school life started from me.
He studied from the first standard to the eighth standard in this school. He's a very intelligent, lovable and caring student. He never troubled anyone. He was the class topper.
My father worked in a high school just across the street from our school as an NCC officer. Even from his early school days, he used to attend the parade at 6 a.m. During inspection, the CO would wonder what grade to award him, as he could excel in all events.
That year, I had to take the students for NCC camp. He was a leader then. He himself arranged for the necessary medical certificates, organized students, took them to the camp and successfully completed the camp. He was even awarded the best cadet.
When he was an NCC candidate, he was very disciplined, humble and polite. I like him a lot for these qualities.
In Jolarpet, one would have never heard of any religious or caste violence, dowry harassment or political clashes. This is only because of Koyil Dasan. He was our teacher. Peravivalan is from the family that taught discipline to this entire town.
In NCC, we used to clean the roads, remove the bushes and unwanted plants in the roadside. I would go barefoot. Once, my foot got scathed by a bottle piece. He found my bleeding foot, came running to me inquiring what happened. I told him what happened. He immediately removed his Hawaii slippers and asked me to wear them. Until then, I never have worn a slipper. We used to see people wearing slipper with wonder.
He was the school pupil leader in the school. Only a top ranker gets that designation.
Apart from excelling in education, he won many prizes in athletics, coco and long jump competitions. He passed the SSLC exam with second rank in school and joined Diploma Electronics Engineering in Krishnagiri Government Polytechnic.
His breakfast in a hurry, he would run to class at 6 o'clock. He would carry his lunch, insisting me to pack more food for his friends in the hostel.
Everyone in college likes his smile. Out of the 200 plus students studied then, he was the best. It's just not my statement. Any of our batchmates you wish to ask will be of the same opinion.
We always used to discuss we should do something for this country by joining defense, and if that was not possible, we should become engineers and create lot of employment opportunities. Today, I provide employment for 150 employees. It is only because of Peravivalan's advice.
On June 10th night, somebody knocked at the door. When I opened the door, I saw many policemen standing outside. They asked me about my son. I told them that he was in the Tidal for higher studies, staying there to help them. They said, if he comes, we will meet him here itself. If not, please bring him to Malligai. Next day, I went to Periyar Tidal. My son was surprised to see me in the morning. I told him that policemen came in search of him that night. He asked me why they were looking for me. I did not have any answer. Then again in the evening I went to Tidal. To my surprise, I saw my husband, the same CBA officers and few employees of the Tidal. They were insisting Peravivalan to tell them where Nalini was. He said that he did not know anything. Then they asked me to come back in the morning to take him back home because they were taking him to Malligai for an enquiry.
Malligai. Special office set up to investigate the Rajiv Gandhi assassination.
Okaran sir. Un per enada?
Arivungaiya.
Ah sattama.
Peravivalan gaiya.
நளினி எங்கடா
தெரியாதுங்கய்யா
முருகனாவ் தெரியுமா
தெரியாதுங்கய்யா
ரெண்டு பேரையும் தெரியாதான் பாத்துக்குங்க சட்டையில் என்னடா ஓட்ட சிரிப்பு குண்டு வெடிச்சப்ப நடந்ததா
இல்லைங்கய்யா வீட்டில் ஆனதுங்கய்யா
விசாரிக்கிற முறையில் விசாரிச்சு உண்மையை கொண்டு வாங்க
When Next morning at Mallihe, Officer Gangadharan told me that my son was not telling the truth. I told him not to tell like that and I asked him to send my son with me. He didn't accept. He didn't even allow me to see my son at least for a second.
The wonderful, cuddled world of Perarivalan that was filled with self-respect, discipline and love turned into a deserted forest hit by thunder. Perarivalan repeated that though he had passionate interest in the freedom of Tamil Eelam and LTTE fighting forward, he knew nothing about Rajiv's murder. Investigation turned deaf.
Then I asked him when I could come back. He told me to go and meet my lawyer. The only lawyer known to us was Mr. Duraiswamy. The lawyer said, O Sundaram's case is also like this. Let us wait for the judgment of that case before filing this one.
Sir,
சோறு தண்ணி எது கொடுக்காதீங்க நீ நைட்டுக்குள்ள வாய திறக்கணும் இல்லாட்டி சாகணும் என்னடா
தண்ணி
தண்ணி இதுக்காக வாய திறப்பியாடா குடுறா தண்ணி குடுறா எத்தனை பேர் எத்தனை பேர் எங்கடா தங்கி இருக்கீங்க
His battered body that became the answer to answerless questions was allowed to relax only when he went unconscious.
We came to know about many things only when we went there in person. Regarding how he was tortured.
Everyone knows their claim that he was not tortured is a huge lie. On paper, CBI is impeccable, but their actual behavior was different.
Court la ayya kekkuradhukku ange adichan inge adichan edha solittirundakoodad avanga kekkura kelviki aama aama nu bal solittu polachu pora valiya paaru இல்ல உங்க ஒப்ப அத்தாலும் தீட்டு வந்து நொங்கு எடுத்துரு நொங்கு
நியூஸ் பப்ளிஷ்ட் இன் தி நியூஸ் பேப்பர் பேரறிவாளன் அரெஸ்டட்
தே அனௌன்ஸ்ட் தட் ஹி வாஸ் கேப்சர்டு நியர் பெரியார் திடல் இன் நியூஸ் பேப்பர்ஸ் மேகசின்ஸ் அண்ட் ரேடியோ தே வர் சேயிங் ஹி வாஸ் கேப்சர்ட் பட் த ஃபேக்ட் வாஸ் தட் வி வாலண்டரிலி ஹேண்டட் ஹிம் ஓவர் டு தெம் But no one revealed that.
They said, when we searched Perarivalan's house, we found many books on LTTE, hence he was arrested. If they had searched my home the same day, they would have found photos of Prabhakaran, Mataya and Kittu. They would have found more books in my home than that. Same with Suresh and Saravanan. Till now, we preserve them as a treasure.
India Today reports he is an expert in making a bomb. How do they know that?
Just because he studied electronics, he knows to make a bomb? Don't they even think about it?
Perarivalan underwent rigorous torture for 2 months. He realized that he is abandoned. Is it a crime to help Tamils of Eelam in line with leaders like MGR and Indira Gandhi? Is it a crime to discard selfishness and cherish selflessness? These questions kept haunting, adding to the physical torture.
ஐயா தியாகராஜன் அவங்களா எழுதின பேப்பர்ல ஏதோ கையெழுத்தெல்லாம் கேக்குறாங்க ஐயா போடலாமாங்க ஐயா
உள்ள அடிச்சு வாங்குற எந்த ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்டும் செல்லாது அதுக்கெல்லாம் கவலைப்படாத கோர்ட்ல பாத்துக்கலாம்
Perarivalan was ignorant of the act called Tada. He had no choice but to sign wherever demanded to save himself from ever-rising torture.
தேதி 15 14 பத்த கையில தூங்க. என்னடா நுன்ற?
ஒண்ணும் இல்லங்கயா.
விலங்கு கட்டி விடுயா. உட்காரடா டேய் உட்காரடா. சேர்ல உட்காரடா.
வேணாங்கயா.
சேர்ல உட்காரறானே?
பரவாயில்லங்கயா.
போய் உட்காரடா.
வீட்டில் அப்பா அம்மாலாம் பார்க்க வந்தாங்களா?
வந்தாங்கய்யா.
நல்லா இருக்காங்களா?
இருக்காங்கய்யா.
எல்லாத்தையும் மனசில் வச்சுக்க. என்னடா படிச்சு பார்த்துட்டு இருக்க? கையெழுத்தை போட்டுட்டு பொழைச்சு போடான்னா சொன்ன தேதியை போடுறேன்னான்னு கொஞ்சம் பாருங்க. கான்ஸ்டபிள் இவனை கூட்டி போயா.
I got married on September 1st. We tried to get bail, but they refused.
Everyone predicted this marriage would get cancelled, but it happened as scheduled.
There was a huge crowd in the marriage hall. It is because of my father. It is because of his character that we got such a huge support.
My youngest daughter was very particular that only a person who respected her brother could be her husband.
I went to jail for the first time to meet Arivu. He spoke to me to find whether I have any reservations due to the case. But it was not a deterrent.
It is a case under TADA. The enquiry was in camera for about 8 years for these 26 persons.
Between the road and the court, I need to cross about 14 checkposts. In each checkpost, they will stop us for enquiry to completely crush our spirit. We would reach the court mentally exhausted.
After each session, our lawyers would come out and say that none of the arguments was diligently recorded.
They will conduct this inquiry behind closed doors. That is, in the process of in camera, with an evil intention of not allowing any single journalist.
Nothing came out in the newspapers or journals, and the public was highly confused. Even those who know some truth were afraid of speaking out.
The case inquiry prolonged for 7 long years in Pundamalli Tada Special Court. The verdict, all the 26 accused were sentenced to death. Tada Special Justice Navaneethan.
In the judicial history, this is the first time all the 26 were given a death sentence.
We were speechless, unable to believe. None could console the other person. Everyone was crying. I have never before seen my father cry.
The Supreme Court condemned that this case would not come under the purview of TADA, acquitting 19 convicts, slapping life imprisonment on 3 and confirmed death sentence on 4 convicts. All the convicts were imprisoned in high security cell of Velo Central Prison.
Perivalan was moved to Velo. He used to ask for books, books of literary value, poetic value. I learned a new dimension of Tamil through him.
Mr. Ramachandra, the first person to be elevated from the second level constable to the highest position of DIG in the history of prisons department. He was awarded the President Award and Anna Medallion of the state.
Despite being a convict, he developed his knowledge. He would teach the inmates and some even showed him their judgments to get his opinion.
In 2002, only 6 inmates were studying. Now, 300 are studying because of Perivalan.
He's very intelligent, smart, cordial, approachable. He's friendly with everyone. He created a lovely environment in the prison.
I was a school dropout. He asked me to complete 10th standard. I refused, but he insisted and made me complete SSLC.
He gave me the confidence and made me complete BA. He made many others like me to study.
Had I behaved properly in society, I would not have gone to jail. Since I got acquainted with a good person, I came out resurrected.
The Magsaysay Award winner for public service for the year 2012, Mr. Kurandai Francis, on Perivalan's request, set up a computer training center at Velour Prison.
The lab was instituted based on my confidence in his talent. An interest to share the knowledge with others. But for him, the venture would not have been successful.
When I got the judgment on my release, I ran to him to show it. He felt very happy for me. He said that I should forget the past and go out as a new person, should take the experience in prison as a lesson and become a relevant person to the society.
He used to be very busy the entire day, never resting even for a moment. When I asked him about it, he said, "You have 24 hours a day, but I have only 12 hours, 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. I'll be housed in the cell by 6 p.m. and allowed to go out the next morning 6 a.m. only. And also he said, I have not seen the moon for the past 21 years.
There are so many talented people in the prison and so many events are organized. I was speechless and surprised.
எங்கள் இன்ப துன்பத்தின் இணையர்களே, சக சிறை தோழர்களே, உங்கள் அனைவரையும் காலை வணக்கம் கூறி அன்போடு அழைக்கிறது புரட்சி கவிஞர் பாரதிதாசன் கலை பண்பாட்டு கழகம்.
I see it Peredivalan as a positive force behind everyone. He is like a university chancellor.
He has written many books, brought out journals, directed stage plays. In my period, Bharathidasan Kalai Kulu was instituted and Peredivalan's play was staged.
இந்த போட்டிகளை சிறப்பாக நடத்தி பரிசுகளை வெற்றி பெற்றவர்களுக்கு வழங்குவதற்கு உதவிய சிறைவாசி திரு பேரறிவாளன்,
There's something many of you don't know about Peredivalan. He plays keyboard very well. He shows his passion in music.
Despite his treacherous condition, he helps others. I feel proud of him. But in fact, he has regrets. Regret about none came to help in the past 21 years of imprisonment.
Peredivalan wrote the book An Appeal from the Death Row in the Jail. The book exposes the contradictions of the case in a lucid language with the expertise of a lawyer. The heart-wrenching voice of an innocent shook the conscience of every reader of the book. Courses studied and certificates received as an inmate. Though he had completed MCA, in order to fulfill a UGC academic requirement, he had to clear plus two exams. In this examination, he scored an excellent 1096 out of 1200.
I was with him for 15 years. He never indulged in any anti-prison activities. His character is the best. Best among all prisoners.
The fact that all the inmates who wrote plus two examinations from Vellore Jail during 2013 had also passed. This clearly stands testimony to prove that a jail could function as a house of redemption and people like Peredivalan can impress and revive the life of many inmates.
My mother was not in a position to pay my school fees. They paid it for me. I scored 479.
Inspired by the initiatives of Peredivalan in prison, Punnappan, a laborer, set up Peredivalan Educational Academy. This academy helps more than 300 Kanchipuram students with school books, fees, and night school facilities.
I scored 438 marks since I studied here.
Peredivalan sharpened his mind in prison rather than agitating against the system. This is what Periyar and Ambedkar preached.
In an interview to a magazine, The Open, CBI Chief Investigating Officer K. Raghottaman admitted that there was no answer to the crucial question, who made the belt bomb, and added that being an abolitionist, he would be happy if these three convicts came out. He also confessed about some oversights and one of them being a tampered videotape that was revealed long after concluding the investigation.
You have investigated this case. You are making charges. You are making charges that there is a suppression of evidence, that there was a tampering of key footage, that there was a videotape, and you are saying that that tape was hidden away, edited, manipulated, and evidence of the people the assassin was interacting with at the venue was erased.
due to the mounting inconsistencies found in the case and the pending MDMA investigation, many presidents deferred the decision on mercy petition. But Mrs. Pratibha Patil signed it. September 9th of 2011 was marked as the date for hanging.
September 9th was marked as the date of execution. When he met me in prison, he inquired only about the status of the water tank facility that was pending. Myself and my engineer were astonished. He was asking for the facility for other inmates, despite his days being numbered.
Three women advocates initiated a fast until death. People took to the roads across the state to stop the hanging. Sengudi, a young activist of Kanchi Makkal Mandram. In order to strengthen the struggle against death penalty and to save the three lives, she sacrificed her life by self-immolation. Sengudi is the only martyr in the world history of abolition of death penalty.
For the past 21 years, I have been running pillar to post. I have been scouting around to garner support. But this girl sacrificed her life. My son burst out in grief when telling about Sengudi. I have never seen him in this condition.
The struggle spread in a frenzy pace across the state, covering all the villages and hamlets, revealing the conscience of the common people. Organizations and parties who were tangentially opposite in policies and principles aligned in a single line to save the three. Everyone raised their voices in unison against the death penalty. Students, human rights activists, lawyers, film personalities, and common people endorsed the struggle.
We will not allow this politically motivated decision to go through, and the death penalty in India ended now.
Death penalty itself is a gross violation of human rights.
Being a mute spectator to an injustice is as good as supporting it.
திருவாளர்கள் சுதேந்திர ராஜா என்கிற சாந்தன், ஸ்ரீஹரன் என்கிற முருகன் மற்றும் பேரறிவாளன் என்கிற அறிவு ஆகியோரின் கருணை மனுக்களை மறுபரிசீலனை செய்து அவர்களின் மரண தண்டனையை ஆயுள் தண்டனையாக குறைக்க நடவடிக்கை எடுக்க வேண்டும் என மேதகு இந்திய குடியரசுத் தலைவரை தமிழ்நாடு சட்டமன்ற பேரவை வலியுறுத்தி கேட்டுக்கொள்கிறது.
On August 30th, a historic, unanimous resolution was passed in the Assembly of Tamil Nadu. Ramjet Malani, Colin Gonzalez and Vaigai appeared for the three convicts and argued against the decision to hang after keeping them as condemned prisoners for over 20 years.
That punishment is unconstitutional. Therefore, you should make some reward. You should make compensation. Compensation is to take away the death penalty.
The High Court ordered a stay for 8 weeks. Though a temporary stay, it was a moment to rejoice after days of peaking tension.
Back in those days, it was law to stone a woman if she was found involved in prostitution. If the prostitution was proved, she would be given the desired punishment. Jesus interfered and said, "Amongst you, whoever have never done a sin shall deal with the first blow." It is obvious to punish a perpetrator, and it's common to sentence them to prison. We can see this in every criminal justice system nowadays. They have the power to do so, but do we have the right to take a life? I do not know. Do we have the license to kill?
The eyes of the angel of justice are tied. What about the vision of the judges who deliver justice?
These persons were put in jail pending execution of the capital punishment for 20 years. They have suffered one punishment called a life imprisonment with the most atrocious and savagery manner.
The room was not even large enough to accommodate my son freely. A restroom within that. After seeing him in his room with never-ending misery, my grief multiplied.
Cruel animals cannot be caged in that way.
As the day of death sentence nears, a convict's mind is filled with rising negative feelings. At the time of execution, a black mask is made to be worn. When the rope is put around the neck, the convict comes to understand the vitality of breathing. As the rope tightens, the tubular veins from the brain leading to the heart are constricted, leading to cerebral edema. Subsequently, the lack of oxygen leads to failure of brain functionality. As the rope still tightens, the C1, C2 vertebral bones, which supports our skeleton, breaks. The person will be dead.
I don't know what's going to happen. I am 65 years old and he is 70. Would he come while we are still alive? Will he step into this house? We are totally uncertain of the future.
Should we always keep anticipating and finally die without seeing him? Or will we see our son like others do? Is our crying.
After being in a jail for 22 years, trying to execute them is an unfair and dogmatic kind of action.
Their offense is unproved, so they are not criminals.
22 years in the jail is equivalent to several executions. Is there not a chance to forgive at all?
They were almost 20 years in jail, and again, putting them into death penalty is not nice, I think.
Based on human values, death penalty is wrong.
They are already endured so much punishment, and I think they should be excused.
Not found for 22 years. And now, are these three the scapegoats?
In a country like India, where corruption is prevalent, even at the level of judges, we cannot expect true, foolproof judgments. In that case, even innocence could be punished.
Ex-Mahila Congress Chief Santa Kumari, who lost her sister in the bomb blast. Sulaiman said the Congress leader who facilitated the public meeting in Sri Perambudur, their current stand.
They are not the real culprits. I have been making arrangements for the meeting for those 3 days, and as I know, they did not come here or participate in the meeting. So is it not a big crime to punish the innocents?
We cannot assume things. Without proof of their crime, they should not be punished.
The human bomb already died. The rest of the perpetrators were shot dead. What else is there? Is that not the end of the story?
They also deserve life.
Sonia Gandhi, the lady born in Italy where the Pope resides, announced that neither she nor her children would endorse hanging the four convicts. This is an important documentation in the history of abolition of capital punishment.
Human mind is subject to change. His feeling and perception is subject to change, and action is subject to change. In this ever-changing ecosphere, to always see a prisoner as a guilty human being is gross misconception.
Mr. Mohan Raj, the CBI officer who investigated the Rajiv murder case.
I have a doubt that this case was not handled appropriately.
The central government has constituted an agency called Multidisciplinary Monitoring Agency. The agency has not yet filed its final report and the whole investigation is still in progress.
Jain Commission was constituted to investigate on the wider conspiracy to do what? To kill Rajiv Gandhi. So without finding the conspirators, what's the use in taking these 26 to the gallows? It's absurd. CBI was just satisfied dealing with the executors and not the conspirators. It's not right on the investigation.
Records of judicial blunders and flawed executions till recent past.
I who ordered the judgment of the Rajiv Gandhi case. Therefore, I thought I am the most competent person to say that. Now, if you are going to implement a capital punishment, means India cannot afford to have two punishments on a single individual for one offense.
Amidst the voices of humanitarians to commute the death penalty just because he has already served 22 years under the shadow of gallows, Perivalan's feeble voice pleading that he is innocent and that he is not begging for life but demanding the neglected justice was never heard and rejected. The only evidence in this case convicting Perivalan is his own confession statement, but Mr. Thyagarajan, IPS, the CBI officer who recorded Perivalan's statement, now reveals that the confession statement was neither recorded completely nor interpreted accurately, and that he knows Perivalan is an innocent. This is a heart-wrenching revelation in the judicial history of India.
I am Thyagarajan. I belong to the Indian Police Service. When Rajiv Gandhi assassination took place in 1991, I was superintendent of police, CBI, Kerala branch. Tamil Terinja or ESP in Murayla, I was also inducted into the team. அப்படி வரும்பொழுது ஒவ்வொருத்தருக்கும் ஒவ்வொரு அசைன்மெண்ட் கொடுக்குறாங்க. எனக்கு வந்து வரும்பொழுது சரி நீங்கள் வந்து இந்த கன்ஃபெஷனல் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் எல்லாம் நீங்கள் ரெக்கார்ட் பண்ணுங்க. ஐ காட் தட் அசைன்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் ரெக்கார்டிங் இது அது மாதிரி. அப்படி பண்ணும்பொழுது நான் எல்லாருடைய ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்டையும் ஒரு 16 or 17 அதை நான் பண்ணினேன். அதில் என்ன ஒரு விஷயம் என்ன உறுத்துது அப்படின்னா, அப்போ வந்து அறிவு என்ன சொன்னார் சார், அப்போ எனக்கு தெரியாது இது எதுக்காக இது வாங்கிட்டு சொல்கிறாங்க என்ன பண்ண போகிறாங்கன்னு இதெல்லாம் எனக்கு தெரியவே தெரியாதுன்னு சொன்னார், ஒரு வார்த்தை சொன்னார். பட் வாக்கு மூலம் எழுதும் பொழுது அவர் எனக்கு தெரியவே தெரியாதுங்கிறத நான் எழுதலை. அப்போ வந்து இன்வெஸ்டிகேஷன் வந்து ப்ரோக்ரஸ் ஆகிட்டுருந்தது, அதனால் நான் அந்த ஒரு ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்டை மட்டும் நான் அதை எழுதலை. நான் தோ ஸ்ட்ரிக்ட்லி ஸ்பீக்கிங் லா எக்ஸ்பெக்ட்ஸ் யூ டு ரெக்கார்ட் த ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் வெர்பேட்டிம், வார்த்தைக்கு வார்த்தை எழுத்துக்கு எழுத்து அப்படியே சொல்லணுன்னு சொன்னாலுமே கூட நடைமுறையில் நாங்கள் அப்படி செய்கிறது இல்லை.
இலங்கை தமிழர்கள் பிரச்சனையை நான் 1983 கவர் பண்ணிகிட்ருக்கேன். பிரபாகரன் நான் இன்டர்வியூ பண்ணியிருக்கேன். எல்டிடி பற்றி எனக்கு தெரியும், ஹவ் எல்டிடி ஆப்ரேட்ஸ் அப்படின்னு. பேரறிவாளன் ஏதோ ஒரு பேட்டரி கொண்டு வர போனாராம், இல்லைன்னா அது பெல்ட்டுக்கு வேறு யாரோ கொண்டு போனாங்களாம். இவங்களுக்கெல்லாம் சொல்லியிருப்பாங்க நீட் டு நோ பேசிஸ், அதாவது இந்த ஒரு செயல் இது நம்ம ஒரு ஆபரேஷன் இருக்கு இதுல உன்னுடைய பங்கு ஒரு பேட்டரி கொண்டு வரதா இருந்தால் அவ்வளோதான் உங்களுக்கு தெரியும் இந்த பேட்டரி அது டிரான்சிஸ்டரில் போட போகிற பேட்டரியா இல்லை எதுக்காக போடுற பேட்டரின்னு அவர் தெரிஞ்சிருக்காது.
Mr. Thyagarajan's revelation that the Supreme Court has superficially inferred something that was never part of this confession statement is a crucial turning point in this case.
Memboka superficially memboka eduthukondu they jump to the conclusion adhaavu therinji sivarasanu ivarum udanda rajiv gandhi kollapada porar rajiv kolaiki idu or bomb panna poranga andha bomb ku ivar battery thevapadudhu idu ella munkootiye therinji ivar poi vaangittu vandarungra maari oru membokana mel nokkiya paarvai illu poitaanga. உண்மை அதுவல்ல, உண்மை அதுவல்ல. ஏன்னா ஒரு கன்ஃபெஷனல் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ல இல்லாத ஒன்றை நாம் வந்து யூகமாக செய்யும் ஸ்பெக்குலேஷன் சொல்லுவாங்க பாருங்க, ஸ்பெக்குலேட் பண்ண முடியாது. இட்ஸ் வெரி டேஞ்சரஸ் டு ஸ்பெக்குலேட். இது நான் அப்பயே நான் ஃபீல் பண்ணேன் பட் அப்போ ஒன்றும் செய்யறதுக்கலாம், அந்த ஸ்டேஜில் ஒன்றும் செய்யறதுக்கு முடியாது. அதனால தான் அறிவினுடைய விஷயத்துல முக்கியமாக ஐ ஆல்வேஸ் ஃபெல்ட் அ லிட்டில் அன்இீசி that the confessional statement has not been appreciated the way it should have been appreciated.
As a prison officer, I have executed many prisoners in the past 40 years, but never felt so mortified when I heard about this execution. As far as I have known them, they do not deserve this punishment.
The accusation against Perarivalan is that he purchased two batteries in the first week of May 1991. But in the intercepted wireless message between Sivarasan and Puttu Amman in the second week of May 1991, Sivarasan clearly states that none knows about Rajiv's assassination conspiracy except Tanu and Subha. This clearly proves that Perarivalan was never part of the conspiracy.
இது அறிவு என்ன சொன்னார், மற்றவங்க என்ன சொன்னார், போலீஸ் ஆஃபீஸர் என்ன ரெக்கப் பண்ணாருங்கிறது ஒரு புக்கம் ஒரு புறம் இருக்க, அங்கே வந்து ஸ்ரீலங்கன் காடுகள் இங்கே இந்திய கடற்கரையிலிருந்து ஒயர்லெஸ் செய்திகள் அனுப்பப்படுகின்றன. அப்படி பார்க்கும் பொழுது ராஜீவ்காந்திக்கு கொலைக்கு முன்னாடி இந்த சிவராசன் ஒரு செய்தி அனுப்புகிறாரு அங்கே எல்டிடி ஹெட் குவார்ட்டர்ஸ்க்கு. இதுவரைக்கும் இந்த விஷயத்தை பற்றி நாங்கள் யாருக்கும் சொல்லவில்லை. Automatically it excludes the prior knowledge that Rajiv Gandhi is going to be assassinated. It excludes the knowledge of everybody else. So this is a very solid, uncontested, unchallenged, unchallengeable evidence.
Whenever there is a suspicion, please don't execute.
After being awarded capital punishment, if an accused proves his innocence, it will be a big defamation to the justice system of India. Then people will lose faith in the Indian legal system.
I have also played a role in the sense that it was me who recorded the confession. And as I said, one thing, confession itself is not very clear. And the benefit of doubt, why the benefit of doubt? Even there is subsequent internal evidence to clearly say that Arivu did not know beforehand that Rajiv Gandhi was going to be killed at all. So if he did not know that that there was going to be killing, how can he make him party to the killing? It is illogical. It is against the evidence on record. Therefore, if you look at it from any angle, it will be miscarriage of justice if the extreme penalty is carried out. It will be very tragic and unfortunate. That is my firm conviction.
In the name of Tamil people, I pray to the government of India, they shall not execute any person in the name of Rajiv Gandhi.
Murugan Sandhan Perarivalan nodi and the terror suspect photographs, adhu dhaan enudaiya manasula irundhathu. And na andha en manasula irundha andha moonu poi padangalukkum avangala nerla paathadhukkum endha sambandhamume illa. They were so cheerful and they were all talking about life beyond prison. Namma andha kuttatha seyala adanal namma video namma release panniduvaanga oru nambikkai. இல்லை இந்தியன் லீகல் சிஸ்டமில் அரசியலமைப்பு சட்டத்தில் வந்து தப்பு பண்ணாதவங்க தண்டிக்கப்பட மாட்டார்கள், எப்படி நம்ம வெளியே வந்துருவாங்க எந்த நம்பிக்கையும் தெரியல. பட் தேர் ஆல் சோ கான்ஃபிடன்ட்.
தே நெவர் தாட் தட் தே வில் பி எக்ஸிக்யூட்டட் பிகாஸ் தே நெவர் டிட் த கிரைம் அண்ட் சோ தே நெவர் ஆன்டிசிபேட்டட்.
ஒரு ஒரு இன்னோசன்ட் லைஃப், அதாவது குற்றமற்ற ஒரு உயிர், எந்த காரணத்துக்காகவும் அதில் வந்து அறம் தப்பக்கூடாது. அது பெரிய ஒரு அநீதியாகும்.
Whenever we take life, some element of suspicion has been overruled by people. Your conscience protests against it.
It is a question of my conscience. If I keep silence, I spoke out.
In very good conscience, I thought it was my duty to get in touch with Arivu and his advocates, bring out the true import of the confessional statement, so that if possible, even at this last minute, we can try and save a precious human life.
I wish and I hope and demand on behalf of the humanist section of Indian people, they shall not be excluded.
Therefore, I am very definite that it is time that they should be freed.
This is Perarivalan's story, not only Perarivalan, but also of Murugan, Santan, Muniyappan, Nedunchezhian, Bulla, Rajona, and many more awaiting death under the gallows of the world. Human beings are not immune to mistakes. Like the accused, the judicial and police officials are also human beings. In this case, not only the convicts are affected by the draconian Tada Act, but the officials who handled it too. The credentials of the officers and judges who spoke out to prevent another judicial blunder will be engraved in the history of abolition. Total abolition of the capital punishment is the only solution to prevent innocents from being executed and evolve as a society driven by human values.